Well, it's time for another speaker's tip. Today, I'm going to talk a little bit more about the stage movement. Now, in the last tip, I actually blocked the stage in six areas and talked about how you can use those six areas to go to a specific scene, holograph, or block the stage so that when you refer back to those points in your speech, you go back and talk in those locations. But maybe you're giving a speech that doesn't have locations in your story. Maybe you're giving some informative speech about, I don't know, the economy or global warming, or I don't know what you're talking about, but you're on a big stage. You still want to use the stage. You still want to have stage movement because you have a big audience out there. And you want to address the audience. So you don't want to just stand in the center of the stage and give your speech. You want to walk around on the stage. So you want to walk over to the right and talk to the people on the right and tell them what you're talking about. And then head back over to the center and over to the left and talk to them. Look up at the balcony and talk to the people up in the balcony and explain what's going on or explain the information you're giving. Here's the key to that. You need to have purpose to your movement. Don't just wander around on the stage. I think we've all seen this. Somebody's just like up walking around, maybe you have a microphone, they're just wandering around on the stage with no purpose. No, walk over and give part of your speech in one location. And then as you transition to another part of your speech, walk over and give that in a different location. Make sure that the movement you have is coordinated with the information you're giving. And it's not just a college professor. This was one of my, I would say, most observed point I had a lot of my professors. They would just stand up in front of the class and wander back and forth because they'd get been teaching this class for 15 years and they just had to recite it one more time to another class for this term. And it's like they're just on automatic doing that. So here's that. Have purpose to your movement. A couple other points. Don't stand too far back on the stage. And I've seen this happen where people are way in the back of the stage. No, come out and get in front of the audience. I've also seen this happen. I've seen speakers, walk out and stand with their feet halfway off the edge of the stage. They're so far out that they're stepping off the edge of the stage. Don't do that. You're invading the audience's space when you do that. Be back from the edge of the stage. And I swear I've seen this over and over again with a number of different speakers. So this is a common issue that can come up. So the point is, if you're using your stage movement, use the stage to talk to the different parts of the audience. And I usually divide it into three parts, center, left, and right. And I'll walk over to the left and I'll talk to that part of the audience as I look across. And then when I make another point, I transition either back to the center or over to the right and talk to them so that everybody feels included in your speech. But make sure that there's purpose to the movement and you're not just wandering around meandering on stage. That's your tip for today. We've got a few more. See you next week.